Hey, what is up, guys? The Dustin Scott Show, episode 5.
We're back, baby.
Let's go. It's been a little while, and we apologize, but we had to take a break. Chris got the sickness.
This fucking asshole was on quarantine.
He was on quarantine. We were not going to go fucking near him for a while.
When I went to the hospital and I told him my symptoms, they told me, here's a mask, go sit down. I sat down.
Yeah.
They called me in the back. I go in the back. They set me in a room. They're like, all right, you're going to be set back here away from everyone else for a while until we can figure out what's wrong with you. I had flu B.
Flu B, and, you know, Chris.
As opposed to flu A, C, D, and all.
Well, there's A, B, and C. Flu B and flu A are pretty much, I looked it up. I was a doctor, and I looked it up. It was the regular flu.
So was it
highly contagious? Yes. And was it any less serious than another flu? No, but it wasn't something. When I heard flu B, I thought, when he told me flu B, I thought, holy shit, this is some super organism that has developed.
Flu B, get the fuck away from me.
When he said flu B and he goes, it's highly contagious and I might die, I literally thought to myself, I'm like,
Chris got the flubs.
Flu turned into something else. There's another form of flu that they had to, they don't even have a name for it. Yeah. It's so deadly that they had to call it flu B.
They said it's the rare kind of flu that people get.
Really?
Yeah. It's more rare than flu A and C. The girl's like, did you get your flu shot this year? I'm like, no, I don't get
no.
She looked at me like I was a retard and kept asking
me questions.
Oh, no.
Okay, here's the problem with flu shot. I'm not against vaccinations, but here's what concerns me. Is when we vaccine ourselves and when we, like, over-prescribe everybody antibiotics for everything, you're just making the fucking viruses stronger, and they eventually adapt to everything.
Yeah.
Now, let me correct myself. I know they don't use antibiotics on viruses, antibiotics for bacteria. But the same idea stands. You keep trying to put too much shit in your body to prevent yourself from getting it. It's going to make itself stronger, and when you finally get it, it's going to shit on you.
It's not that vaccinations are bad. Okay, you need vaccinations. Vaccinations don't work, or they mutate because not everyone gets them. So one out of the three people here, let's just say Chris doesn't get vaccinated, okay? The shit works, okay? It only doesn't work. If I get sick because of Chris, it's because he didn't get vaccinated.
Well, no, what I'm saying is if you get vaccinated, it now makes you resistant to the flu. Well, now the flu has to become stronger because it's going to come back eventually.
Let me tell you this. Well, if everyone in the world got vaccinated for each disease, there wouldn't be the fucking flu.
Like, no, there would be.
The flu would die out.
No, it wouldn't die out.
Yes, it wouldn't.
It wouldn't
die out. Viruses can't die out. They just continuously mutate. That's why we have a flu pandemic like every 50 years. And the problem with a disease dying out is that eventually people don't have an immunity to it. So if it does come back, it starts a pandemic and kills a lot of people. Like a perfect example of one, smallpox. Nobody's had smallpox in forever. But if smallpox does come back, it's a fucking biohazard because nobody has any immunity to smallpox and that shit kills.
Well,
look at polio.
Speaking
polio. When they completely wiped out polio
using the vaccinations. That's what I'm saying. They wipe out polio because they use vaccinations.
But the flu is just like
I feel like it would help if people actually got their kids fucking vaccinated. Yes. Diseases mutate, and yes, it's going to be hard to get rid of them, but it definitely would help if fucking redneck A would get her goddamn child vaccinated. I'm sick of going to a place and her kid fucking sneezing on me while I'm trying to make a living. Do you know how many times at Panera a kid fucking comes up to me and says, Mister, can I have a lid for my... and then sneezes all over my fucking arm. I want to smack the kid with my diseased hand just to give it back to him. Well, speaking of chicken pox...
I didn't say chicken pox, but you know what? This will do.
Yeah,
I said smallpox.
Oh, I'm sorry. It's the same fucking thing.
No, they're a big motherfucking difference.
Well, speaking
fuck
of
you.
Pox. It's a pox.
Speaking of pox,
Alex brought this story to us. Facebook deletes fake child cancer posts.
All right, so here's the fun with this one, guys. So Facebook had to delete two accounts that used stolen photographs from this woman. She had posted, I can't remember exactly why, this woman posted a picture of her kid on Facebook with really bad chicken pox. Like, this shit was horrible. Well, some random-ass Facebook account that we all run into these occasionally. It used that woman's post about her kid, said the kid had cancer on his new post, and then it would say, like, one Facebook is going to donate $1 for every, like, $2 for every comment, $4 for every share, and $8 for something else.
That's fucked up.
Yeah, it's insane. It actually ended up getting like 1.2 million shares.
Oh my God.
241,000 likes and 143,000 comments. And I'm like, people are so fucking stupid.
You know, it's sad when we live in a society where you were exploiting a kid with a disease for Facebook likes and shares and comments is morally okay. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, people would rather do that than to actually donate money to help disease.
Or, you know, do something more productive than go up on Facebook and be like
statuses. Just the so you
no,
can
or no, make
it's not even the people who like it, they just come across it. It's the people who make these kinds of posts. You know what I'm saying?
We need to get smarter though, because people literally buy in every fucking
clickbait
thing.
Clickbait has gone too far.
It's past clickbait. Everything's just fake news. Everything. We're fake news. We are.
Did you hear Trump? He was.
No, you know what? We're inaccurate news.
Yeah, we're not. It's not that we're trying to be fake. We're not bringing you false information.
We're just
some of our information is just not all there, like killing out diseases and smallpox.
We don't know everything we're saying.
We're just trying to entertain.
True. Basically, we're a radio show hosts.
Yeah, Trump. I mean, let's think of it this way. This show, there are facts are 10 times better than that of Alex Jones.
True. Yes.
We're not spouting off about lizard people. I don't think Hillary's a good person, but I don't think she's a demon.
Not yet. Now, depending on what we want our view count to be, we might introduce a lizard people segment, but we'll get to that down the road.
This weekend, who's a lizard person? Did you see Jennifer Lawrence's tail?
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
Shocking photo proves Matthew McConaughey's a lizard person.
If anyone is a lizard person, it's Matthew McConaughey. Have you seen his fucking face?
What kind of fucking accent does he have?
That's a very good question.
No one in the fucking world uses that accent. What language does he speak to have that accent?
It's like a cheap southern accent. It's like a Walmart brand southern accent.
It's a southern accent that has cockiness to it. And it's like,
I'm gonna fuck your bitch. No, that don't work. Bring me some of that good old pone tang.
Hopefully, and I know Facebook wanted to start removing
fake news,
clickbait, and fake news.
You know what they need?
I hate Facebook. I never go on Facebook.
He had to start doing that because he was taking down so many fucking meme pages that it's so.
The meme pages aren't what's. Okay, he's going after the wrong people. He should be going after
BuzzFeed,
InfoWars,
BuzzFeed,
Daily Mail,
BuzzFeed.
BuzzFeed.
If I see one more goddamn BuzzFeed video shared, I'm going to lose my shit.
Which type of pizza are you? Number 4 will shock you.
Stop being racist. 20 things white people ruined in 2016.
Yeah, yeah. MTV. MTV is a good example of that.
The only people talking about this half the time are other pissed off white people. Let me tell you, in all of my existence, I've met maybe 2 or 3, you know, people who are black, Hispanic, Asian, or whatever. They genuinely confronted me with a race problem. And guess what? They weren't rude about it. Everybody who
like
I can
a race as a you were being racist or just
no like
the general race problem.
General race problem. Nobody dares accuse me of being racist because I discriminate against everybody without exception.
That's how we all should be.
Yeah, we don't just
everyone
hate,
should be an.
We
asshole.
Don't hate one person. We hate everyone.
Yeah, like I don't see
equally.
I don't see you according to the color of your skin. I see you according to the degree of your stupidity. Now, if the color of your skin somehow is intertwined with that,
and if you take that the wrong way. That's your fault. It's not intentional. It just happens to work out.
I'm like a lawyer after I get paid. Not my problem.
Yeah. All right. So let's move on to let's move on to this story.
Chris, you got to get this.
How
one.
Do you?
It's all you, baby.
How do you say his last name?
Yiannopoulos.
Really?
Yeah, that's how I said it. Like I just when I look at Greek last names, I just ignore most of
Is
the
it
letters.
Greek?
Yeah. Look at that, Polis. Of course, look at that shit.
That's definitely Greek. That's too many letters.
That's like I'm.
See, I don't.
That's like
don't
asking if Sanchez is Hispanic.
If I see that many letters and they aren't in a different language, I immediately assume Greek.
Look at all the O's, bro. Greek is a language of O's.
There are three O's in his island.
Kronos. Come hey, on.
There you go. Milo Yiannopoulos quits Breitbart News, right? Breitbart?
Breitbart, yeah. I think that's it.
Oh, man.
What that's was his poor choice of words? What right,
he
say?
Oh, Chris, give it to him.
Okay. A video resurfaced yesterday showing Milo talking about pedophiles. He said most relationships between 12 or 13, I'm not sure which age he used. We're not fake. I don't want to be fake news right now. But he said most relationships between adult and 12 or 13-year-olds are consensual. And the fact he was molested when he was a kid made him better at oral sex.
Okay, I'm going to stop you right there.
Justin said, hold the fuck up.
All right. Were you molested as a child?
No.
Were you molested as a child?
By the public education system.
Does that make you better at oral sex?
I don't think so.
I'm trying to. Okay, now hear me out. I'm trying to picture this in my head. I'm seeing a graph, and I'm trying to find the correlation between molestation as a child
and oral sex.
Okay, now here's the thing. He is a homosexual. Fantastic. People do that now.
Mm-hmm.
As if it wasn't happening until the late 2000s. Nobody's getting fucked in the butt until this century.
Hold on. Now, I'm not saying it wasn't a thing. What I'm saying is more, I'm saying
it's more accepted.
In middle school, I remember hearing kids saying, "You're a fucking fag. Don't talk to me." That same person is now a sophomore in high school. And is blowing three dudes in the basketball locker room.
That's what I'm talking about.
Everyone, I'm telling, no, I've noticed that. And it's not that I'm against it. I don't fucking care. That's the thing. But I've noticed, and I don't know if, because you came to Parma in what, sophomore year?
My freshman year.
Wait, where were you before
that? I went to Lakewood. I went to Cleveland, Lakewood, then Parma.
So Chris should know even better. He was in the land of the faggots. Lakewood.
Yep.
Yeah.
I was in Flakewood.
Lakewood is our San Francisco.
Everyone called each other. Everyone was like, "We know this is a city of gay people, Flakewood." I didn't meet one gay person there. That was
a suspect. Can you imagine out of the street? Where are the fags?
Yeah, everyone's like, "Yeah, this city also has so many fucking gay people." And I'm like, I haven't seen one gay person.
I think what they mean by
where are they at? No.
Straight up, I think what they mean by gay is happy. Because let me tell you, one time a few years back, I went to a Lakewood McDonald's. I swear to God, I went to a 5-star restaurant. The service was so quick.
I love
these
those
people
McDonald's.
These people were
really fancy looking ones.
Oh my God,
the chandeliers. Yeah.
These were the happiest people. They're like, "Hi, how are you? Can I take your order?" I finished my order. A fucking sexy black bitch came out to the car and gave me a hand job while she was feeding me and told me to have a nice day. Like, you don't get that type of
if
service.
That doesn't around. Give you 5 stars. I don't know.
Those Yelp reviewers were like, "Hot damn, this McDonald's."
The food wasn't that good, but the hand job, A1.
Okay, so let's go back to Milo. How the fuck does being molested as a child, was that a joke?
He said it jokingly.
So that wasn't, was this a real?
It was not serious. He didn't mean it.
So did he actually get molested as a child?
He lost his virginity, but he was joking.
He lost his virginity at like 13 in an orgy with a drag queen.
Yeah.
Jesus.
What?
That's our new soundbite from Dustin. It's a pause. Jesus.
All right. That's great. Alex, hold on 1 second. I'm going to pause the show. Not recording it. Pause. I need you to hold my mic for 1 second because right. Your mic is pissing me off.
Okie dokie, buddy.
But yeah, he was molested by 3 men. And he's put all 3 in jail.
Dustin's fucking with my microphone.
That's
dude, why is Dustin's microphone got a bigger head than mine? What are you trying to say, bro?
What do you think it means?
Big snake under a big rock, right?
Yeah, of course. I have size 13 shoes. What does that mean? I've got big hands. What do big hands mean? Big gloves. What does that mean? Big feet. does that mean? Big socks.
They all have meanings.
They all have meanings. All
right.
So
with our ADHD,
this dude was molested as a teenager.
Three times.
Three times by his uncle or three different people?
All I know is three different people molested him.
Man, he was in demand.
What a fucking life.
Yeah.
Man, at the age of 13, I was playing The Legend of Zelda in my suburban white home.
At 13, I was just learning how to correctly masturbate. Like, I went from humping the couch to learning how to use my hand.
You know what that, you ever see that show Blue Mountain State?
Yes.
Yeah.
Who hasn't seen that show?
Do you remember that episode where
the pocket pussy?
No. It's the episode where they're about to win the state championship, but there's riots, or they're afraid that there's going to be a riot, so they end up staying.
Yeah.
Or no, they delayed the game another day, so the rival team is at Blue Mountain State and they're all hanging out and they're playing
beer pong.
Yeah, and she calls him couch because he was
humping,
he was fucking the couch instead of her. Hey, whatever works. That's all I
can say. As long as it ain't sandpaper, get her done.
So he joked about pedophiles. Go ahead, take the story.
He joked about pedophiles.
So now he's getting that is what makes him get fired, but not everything else he said about other people.
Technically, he wasn't fired. He resigned.
He resigned. Yeah,
because. A senior editor at Breitbart said that if he was continued to be employed, they would quit. So a lot of people were really mad about it.
Well, at least he did the right thing, and resigned instead of making someone else quit. I mean,
do you know what?
But also on the other hand, if they want to quit because of him, that's their fault, not his.
Yeah.
You know, that's the thing that I get fed up with is there's free speech, but then. There's consequences to your free speech.
Yep.
With me, if I say something that offends you, that's your fault that you're offended. That's not my fault. If you got offended by it,
And look who said it, Milo. Milo says.
Out of everyone. Now I can see if
Milo's existence itself is actually. No,
I can see
let alone what he says.
I can see if Bill Gates was at a Microsoft press conference and said, "Yeah, those pedophiles, damn good people." Fucking oral sex.
Yeah.
I could see him resigning from a position like that. It's Milo. He called a social justice warrior a fat fucking cow in her face.
He says he'd rather have cancer than feminism.
Yes. That's the other thing. That, I think, would probably be more offensive than pedophile.
Yeah.
Pedophilia is not a great thing, but neither is cancer.
This whole man's life is basically a dank meme. He's a gay Catholic. If that doesn't scream dank
meme. If
that
doesn't scream contradictory, I don't know what does.
Paradox.
X-Files theme insert here. Wow.
Twilight Zone.
What a man. What a life this man has lived.
Oh, man.
I've only heard the very small snippet of it.
His publisher also canceled his book.
No pun intended, but the tip of it.
Can you imagine trying to be this guy's... this guy's fucking PR rep. Can you imagine having to be Milo's PR rep?
He didn't actually mean pedophiles are good. He just meant...
It was taken out of context. We don't know what the fuck he meant. All right.
It was fake news.
Sucks, though. His life just completely
he'll be fine. People eat the shit out.
Yeah, no, he'll bounce
him
back.
Alex Jones can get a radio show.
No, dude, I think... I think if they had a show together, it'd be more like them fighting each other, because you know
it would.
Alex Jones is a Bible thumper. He fucking hates gay people. Put a gay person in front of him, he'll have a
that
fucking
agrees with them is gonna get even better.
No, it would. I would be. I'd watch that.
I would
subscribe.
We need
to
put that shit
just like you should subscribe to the Dustin Scott Show. We're not
shameless advertising.
Subliminal messaging. Inside of our show, but
that
we're
should be our slogan. We're
you.
Not fake news.
Kill John Lennon.
Kill the Kardashians.
Kill the.
Damn it, Butters.
Did you ever see that picture of she's wearing a Slayer shirt? Kylie Jenner is wearing a Slayer shirt, and then the Slayer had a concert, and he wore a Kill the Kardashians shirt.
They need to die. I'm tired of the Kardashians. They don't even need
to
die.
Somebody just needs to put them. You know what she should do? Ultimate punishment. Put them in a room, all of them together, completely naked with no makeup, and the whole room is made out of mirrors.
Fat shame them?
Ooh. No, they'd Photoshop the mirrors.
God damn.
The mirrors would form into
according to their expectations.
These must be one of those funhouse mirrors.
This is a
Bruce, what are
no,
you?
No, those are regular mirrors. No, those are funhouse mirrors.
Bruce, what are you today? I don't know. Let me look in the mirror.
Jesus Christ.
They have self-projecting mirrors.
Yeah.
How you think you look is how you actually look.
Holy shit. All right, I'm sorry.
Wait, hold up.
Let's go on to this now. I'm looking at we have a bunch of stories that we have lined up for you guys today.
Fucking Goku. That's Super Saiyan level 1.
We have, okay, so this next story, let me just read you the headline. Transgender Texas teen wins regional wrestling title in controversial fashion.
Clickbait, warning, clickbait.
Not really clickbait. It's actually pretty solid.
I know, I wish it was clickbait.
Now, I'm going to let me put up a picture for you guys to see. This is a girl. This girl looks like fucking Goku went Super Saiyan in a wrestling tournament. Now, what this story pretty much is, this was one of Chris's stories, and this Texas teenager at a high school wrestler, Mac Beggs, right off the bat, what fucking parents named their daughter Mac?
That's his transition name.
Oh, that's his transition name.
Yeah.
Still a really bad name.
Yeah.
They could have chosen any name. They chose Mac.
You're looking at a 110-pound girl.
No, you're looking at a 110-pound girl, soon-to-be fucking guy.
So Mac Beggs is making waves as he declares his gender identity while competing against athletes of his gender at birth.
That ain't fucking fair.
No.
So pretty much what this means is that he or she, she's not a full man.
Yeah.
She's taking testosterone to transition into a male, but is still a female.
Yeah. Due to the laws, she has to compete based on what gender is on her birth certificate. She said she'd rather fight boys.
I would let her fight boys. if I was a girl and I walked in, okay, hold on. You can tell this is Texas because they have a women's wrestling team.
Yeah.
Never in my life did I ever hear. I remember Alex wrestled as a kid.
Texas women, oh my God, they have man hands. Each and every one of them. A hand job from one of them, your dick's gonna fall.
It's fucking mashed potatoes down there. By the end of this.
It's like an autistic kid squeezing a cat. That's what a hand job from a Texas girl
sound bite.
Jesus Christ. Oh my God.
We just broke a record for most created sound bites in one fucking podcast.
Would you let your daughter go against someone like this?
No.
You wouldn't?
No.
What if they called you bigoted?
How is it bigoted?
Well, because she's still by law.
They're taking testosterone. If she wasn't taking testosterone, I'd let it happen. But testosterone is involved, and I don't like that.
I don't like the testosterone flowing all over my daughter.
That's one way to put it.
You guys are in rare form today. Chris compared a hand job to an autistic kid squeezing a cat.
A hand job from a Texas woman.
Shut up.
Now, not all women would.
Now you're using fake news.
Like, can you imagine that as a fetish? Where you like, oh, my dick to be mashed potatoes when you're done.
Can you just rip it off? How do you like going up to a prostitute in Texas?
Glue it to my forehead and take it.
Put it back on.
Way to go.
I'm bleeding.
Medic.
They have the EMTs.
Come over with a fucking defibrillator. Oh my,
EMTs are outside.
All right,
what happened? She ripped his dick off.
Medic!
We need a doctor.
Don't do it.
And then you got that one asshole physical trainer in the background. Just put ice on it. Hey.
It's off.
Your high school wrestling coach. Ice it.
You know, just sending all these fucking assholes to Syria. Just ice it. No, they're over there. Get it?
Oh, my God.
Get it? Get
hey, baby, what's your name? They call me Clamps.
Can you imagine the amount of effort needed to rip a dick off?
No, hold on. You'd be surprised because they say it takes about as much pressure as for to bite your finger off. You'd be surprised.
Who is they and who? How did they find this out?
Scientists in their science lab in the clouds. They did it. They took a finger and they bit it. And it takes only about as enough. It just needs enough pressure as about eating a baby carrot, and it'll just fucking snap right off.
Ow!
Have I ever attempted it? No. I like to keep my fingers.
Don't try that at home.
But that's what they say. Maybe it's one of those things where they say it, but you don't want to try it to see if it's true.
You're just gonna take their word for it.
Yeah, that guy probably knows a thing or two about
if he's gonna make that bold of a claim.
Did she win the regional championship?
Bet you she did, bro. She probably picked up these girls, did some pancake shit in the air. No, better yet, fucking like
fucking Andre the Giant.
Spinning them like some Italian pastry dough.
I asked because
mi amore.
I asked because what a fucking comeback that would be. If your daughter went against this fucking gargantuan of a woman and won, could you imagine? Like, coach, I don't know if I can't. No, you got this. All right. And then she ends up winning. Here's your state championship belt. Do they get wrestling belts?
Do you get a trophy?
No. Do you know how fucking awesome that would be? If you go to high school, a high school wrestling team, and you got fucking wrestling belts. Holy shit, dude.
Wrestling
get your
like
own entrance and the lights are going off.
Oh, my God.
Fucking costumes. Oh, my God.
So many people would join wrestling.
If I had known that they do that, I would have joined the
if
wrestling.
If they did that,
I would have gotten my fat ass into a fucking onesie.
Hair tied up like you have it now.
Hair tied up. Sumo diaper on just to get a wrestling belt.
First a onesie, then a sumo diaper. Are you doing both at the same time? A sumo diaper onesie? The whole
if they don't allow one, I'm doing the other. And if they don't allow both, I'm doing both. Holy shit. All right. Here's another story.
This one I loved. So you guys probably heard about the escaped bull that was just rampaging through New York City.
And you know, I honestly didn't hear about this until you said something. I'm like, what?
Yeah. Now,
is
Dustin, scroll down real quick.
Excuse me.
All right. So basically, like, this bull was from a slaughterhouse, and somehow, some way, it got out. They were planning on.
His name is Hope. Hope escaped.
No. It's not Hope.
Oh, I'm sorry. I read the wrong thing. I'm sorry. Never mind. Why would they name a bull who's about to be slaughtered? I don't know.
You're fake news, Dustin. You're fake news.
Fake fucking news, bro.
You're what Donald Trump called CNN.
I'm naming the bull Hope.
Did you hear what Donald Trump said to CNN? He's like, I'm changing you guys. You guys aren't fake news anymore. You're very fake. Right to a reporter. I laughed so hard.
You're very fake.
Dustin, bring
word
up that
play.
While I'm working on this article, bring up that video. We've got to play that video.
All right.
So anyways, the bull, basically, long story short, escaped the slaughterhouse, was running around Queens, raising absolute hell.
Queens? Holy shit. Could you fucking imagine?
ASAP Rocky's in there smoking a blunt.
I was going to say, some dude's on his porch smoking a blunt and just sees a bull and like five cop cars and you're just like... I think I'm going to quit.
Too much sauce.
Damn, dude.
Damn, dude. What the do we do?
This ain't weed.
CNN is
very fake news.
Very
dude,
fake.
Oh, my God. I couldn't fucking. I would love to see that. You ever see that video? The guy's watching TV. He's videotaping. He's watching TV, and it's a high-speed car chase. and there's a helicopter videotaping it, like showing it on the news and everything. They're broadcasting it, and he goes out his window, and they come around the corner. I would love for something like that to happen. Like one of those one in a million things, like one in a million chances. Oh my God.
Just type in the video section.
InfoWars. That's where we're gonna.
That's where we get our news.
Damn it, Alex Jones. Okay. Maybe it'll come up.
I doubt it.
Damn it. Go to videos. Like, hit the videos thing, you fucking moron.
Hey. Shut the fuck up.
What was that?
I have one hand.
What was that fake news?
You mean your fucking fake news? Is that,
should I just change the name of this? Should we literally be called Welcome to Fake News?
We are fake news.
Oh, geez.
I think you have too many tabs open.
Really?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, I think that might be it. See, there it goes.
Hey!
Wow.
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 All right. While this is loading, I'm going to play a clip.
That y'all going to love
this, for this bull.
It's a cow.
It said bull.
Bull, cow. It's got...
Aren't they the same thing?
No. Bull is a male motherfucker with horns. Cow's the bitch whose nipples you squeeze for the milk.
So the cow is the female.
Yeah. Chris, you should know this. You look like you're Southern.
I...
Wow.
Damn it, they did tell me that.
All right. Let's play this clip real quick.
Oh, God. I can't wait to see this.
It's in the video. It's like...
News conference and probably speeches. I certainly didn't win by people listening to you people, that's for sure. But I'm having a good time. Tomorrow they will say, Donald Trump rants and raves at the press. I'm not ranting and raving. I'm just telling you, you know, you're dishonest people. But, I'm not ranting and raving. I love this. I'm having a good time doing it. But tomorrow the headlines are going to be, Donald Trump rants and raves. I'm not ranting and raving.
If
go ahead.
I may just one more follow.
Should I let him have a little bit more? What do you think, Peter? Peter, should I have let him have a little bit more? Sit down.
Just because of the attack of fake news and attacking our network, I just want to ask you, sir.
I'm changing it from fake news, though.
Doesn't that undermine...
Very fake news.
I know, but aren't you...
Damn. Wow.
Okay, you know what?
But honestly, he's not wrong.
He's not wrong, but it really, really worries me with how he goes at people. Like it,
you know,
he doesn't even fucking make sense.
No, I know, but what worries me more than him ranting and going after other people is that he's more worried about his approval rating and his TV ratings and his speech ratings than actually getting stuff done. What is one piece of legislation that he's done this month?
Well, he's done a lot because of executive orders, but here's the reality. Okay.
Executive orders, but something that actually matters. He fucked up the oil line. He's already given – the Environmental Protection Agency, they're getting fucked left and right because of executive orders. Name one good piece of legislation he's passed since he's been president.
He's trying.
He's worried.
Lifetime ban on – I can't remember what – it had something to do with lobbyists. There was something I liked. But besides that, here was what I was going to say is – the really ironic point of his presidency is, as you know, you fans probably know, I'm not a Hillary supporter in the slightest, nor am I a Trump supporter in the slightest. I still would have taken Trump over Hillary, and well, that's what I fucking got, I guess. But here's the real irony.
So you would have taken Trump over Hillary.
Yes, but we all know I didn't vote for
either
of the motherfuckers.
But that's the thing. I talked to like Austin or Joey, and they would have much rather had Hillary than Trump, and I'm just like... I couldn't teeter either way.
Here's why I say it's a really fucked situation. How I'm realizing it's so fucked right now is Trump, ironically, he said he was going to get into Washington to drain the swamp and to get things moving. Ironically, the American people elected an outsider so that things could change, but because he's an outsider, there's more gridlock than ever. We try to bring somebody from the outside, and ironically, even... things are changing even less than they were before. Like, we were bitching about, oh, all these longtime Washington people, nothing's getting done. It's the status quo. It's now even more status quo nobody can get along. Here's what worries me. On the reverse end, let's say Hillary would have got in. It would have been the status quo, but it would have been a lot more because guess what? And this is why I'm kind of glad Trump's in office. At least I know he can't get anything done. He can only cause so much harm because he has resistance. Hillary's been in the game for 40-plus years. So if she wants to get something done and if she wants to fucking kill somebody over it, she'll do it. and she'll get whatever the fuck she wants done. Done.
Well, that, but I mean, well, that's the thing. No one likes Trump. That I mean,
Does Trump like Trump?
His supporters do, but what I'm saying is, people who actually are in office right now and are
can't stand them
dealing with it, they can't stand them. So nothing is getting done. And that's why, that honestly, if there was one thing I would have rather voted for Hillary for than Trump, was for this reason right now. Obviously, Hillary isn't liked by Republicans, but at least some stuff would maybe pass faster than this. You know what I'm saying?
Well, yeah. Nothing's gone through Congress yet. This is really his first couple months of presidency.
Even just him trying to get people on his cabinet.
Well, the cabinet stuff, yeah, I don't agree with a lot of his cabinet
picks. They haven't even gotten to the other stuff because they can't get people to work for him. You know what I'm saying? They keep voting against him.
Yeah, because people are so... I don't agree with everything Trump does. I don't agree with his rhetoric. But a lot of his cabinet picks aren't good. And even the good ones, like General Mattis to be Secretary of Defense.
Secretary of motherfucking Defense.
Defense.
That's like, he had to go through so much shit because Trump picked him. Like, just because Trump picked him, they assume he's
already
bad.
On a hit list.
Yeah.
That's not fair. There's too many people now, instead of actually looking into him, especially with the people, instead of actually looking into these people and seeing what they've done and what they stand for, they just automatically assume he's the devil.
Yeah.
We don't want him. He's a Trump supporter. Trump wants him. So obviously he's bad. And that's the thing that makes it. That's why I hate political parties. That's why I don't think there should be Democratic or Republican or liberal or conservative. You may have liberal or conservative views, but then to just lay, like my father only votes Democrat. He could literally be robbing people point blank with a gun, and he'll only vote Republican. My aunt and my uncle, you've met them. Ellen. Yeah. They only vote Republican. They could be raping Milo,
and they're still gonna vote for.
And they're still gonna vote for them.
That's ridiculous.
No, that's how my girlfriend. That's how her one grandma is no matter what, she always votes Democrat. And it's like it's a generational thing, which is what pisses me off.
It's very generational.
Okay, and you know what? I'm gonna say some straight shit that's gonna get me fucking arrested, and I can't wait to say this because I've been waiting to fucking say this for a while. Is fuck old people. Fuck everybody who wants Medicare and Medicaid and anything else at this point. Because let me tell you, these old ass motherfuckers have spent 2-3 decades ruining the U.S. economy.
Yeah. If I hear one more, and we're expected
to pay into Social Security. They want their benefits. Here are the two most entitled groups on the planet: young lazy motherfuckers and old entitled motherfuckers that think they still deserve their pension plans and their Social Security and their Medicare and their Medicaid after they fucked everything up.
They destroyed our economy and then expect us to fix it.
Oh, no. They expect us to take care of them. Sorry, Grandpa. You ain't getting that fucking heart surgery. There's a little 10-year-old kid
honestly,
that needs it instead.
I've said it before. If I had the option to not pay into Social Security or Medicare, I wouldn't either. We're not going to have it.
No.
We're not going to have it.
And the people who we're giving it to have fucked us.
It's completely unfair.
They have
when you were crying as a child and your mom comes up to you and says, stop crying or I'm going to give you something to cry about, you thought that she was going to hit you. But really, they were going to destroy the housing market.
That's what fucking happened.
Like, it's so fucking we're going into a future that we have no idea what it's going to be like because of how bad
it's already
the
fucked.
Past generations
fucked
us.
It's already fucked.
Well, I mean.
The thing that pisses me off the most is if we had someone who ran for president who is at the age of 35 to 40, was on the younger side of things would be totally different because they know it's fucked. They know their parents fucked them. They know their grandparents fucked them to where we have 3 70-year-old fucking candidates running for president who fucked us.
Bernie Sanders was halfway in the coffin.
They were all in the coffin.
They were all ranting from coffins on stage.
Fucking Hillary Clinton couldn't stand up long enough to give a speech. Do you see her fall on the way back to her car? She was dying mid-campaign.
They're doing fucking...
The only reason she's still alive is because she doesn't have the stress of being president.
Because she's a fucking lizard person.
Donald Trump's in a fucking hospital bed about to die, saying Hillary Clinton doesn't have the stamina to take a breath from oxygen tank to run for president.
Oxygen mask. I'll tell you what...
If these candidates get any older next election cycle, we might as well just dig up the bodies of Abe and George and put them on the podium.
Well.
Bring out the founding fathers.
You might as well just fucking find Abraham Lincoln's coffin and bring him back. We'll emancipate white people.
What?
I don't know.
Emancipate the dead.
Emancipate the dead. The dead, we'll make the dead great again.
The dead deserve Social Security benefits.
So the last thing on
our minds,
the last thing that I have for you guys today is we're going to start a new thing, and it's once a week. Now, see, I don't know if you guys on YouTube look these up, but for whatever reason, I have a fascination with these videos. It's something I can't control. Alex and Chris hate these videos, but they're cringe compilations. They fascinate the hell out of me. And for those of you who put them together and spend the time to look for those videos, good for you. Are you really helping anyone out? No. But good for you. You spent time and effort into making these 44-minute compilations.
You made Dustin smile.
You made me smile once a week.
You made me cringe.
You made Dustin nut.
No, not nut. I can't nut after watching those.
The food reviews.
This
make
is
me nut.
Repellent. You can't nut after these. So what we're going to start doing is we're going to find the cringe video of the week.
And we're going to play it just for you guys.
And we're going to play it for you guys. And now these are videos that Chris and Alex have never seen. I obviously have to look these up, so I will see them beforehand. But
is that mozzarella sticks inside of a...
Don't look at it, Chris.
That looks really good.
Do you guys think anybody's ever tried to shove a Miracle Whip jar up their asshole?
I don't see why not.
I don't know.
How big?
Let's ask Yahoo.
Nah, ignorance is bliss, bro.
There's some things that people would rather
There's
have
just
not
some things that we shouldn't know. History.
No, yeah. Dustin, speaking of that earlier today.
Yeah.
The shit I wish I didn't know. For all you, I'm going to keep it anonymous, but...
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah. I know what you're talking.
Somebody.
Oh,
all right, guys.
Oh,
so
my God.
This is,
I asked him. I was like, do I know this guy?
This is the last story before we go to our cringe video. But this is going to make you cringe. Don't you worry.
It's cringe.
This is like a cringe. This is a cringe appetizer for you folks. And the video will be the main course. So I have a friend of mine who he's a little strange.
He needs to get his life together.
He really does.
He truly does.
Genius. Decide that he was going to get a tattoo of his ex-girlfriend's initials on his chest.
Oh, my God.
Here's the catch.
Wait, it gets better. Yeah. Here's the catch, guys.
Ex-girlfriend.
Who is currently, you guessed it, engaged and soon to be married.
Is he doing this in an attempt to get her back?
I don't know what he's doing. I don't want to know what he's doing. And with that, start the video, Dustin.
I could think of no more cringe of a way to go into this.
Here we go. Hello, and welcome to the first episode of Noah's Feud Review. Today we will be reviewing Quest Miracle Whip. In the Quest Miracle Whip, there is 30 calories per serving.
He's not actually going to eat it, is he?
I personally have enjoyed Miracle Whip on quite a few occasions, so this should be pretty interesting. I have never ate a whole spoonful at one time. So, as you can see, the jar is almost empty because I love Miracle Whip, so I like Miracle Whip. But you can see the texture, very creamy. Alright, so give me try some. Let me get some out of here.
No.
Okay, so there you can see.
Oh my God, that's so much.
One spoonful of Miracle Whip.
I'm so uncomfortable.
Let's try it. very strong. Very strong taste. Hard to digest. But overall, it's still Miracle Whip. And, you know, I love Miracle Whip, so. It's alright. I mean, I could eat a little bit more. I mean,
I bet you can.
So,
put that spoon down,
overall, I will have to give Kraft Miracle Whip.
That's fucking disgusting.
Original dressing.
Why is the first thing
the food
you
scale rating?
Fucking test Miracle Whip.
7 out of 10. Thank you for watching, and stay tuned for the next episode.
What'd you guys think?
That's fucking disgusting.
I didn't know Cartman does food reviews.
Would you guys subscribe?
No.
First of all, his fucking dresser is fucking in camo.
Oh my god.
That's my first concern.
Oh my god. There's a possibility he might have sex one day. That's a bigger concern. There's a possibility of reproduction.